Good morning, students. This is your math teacher Shweta Bajaj. I hope you all are doing well. Here, I'm back again with chapter number 2, whole numbers. But before starting, firstly, please like and subscribe my channel so that you get the video notifications on time. And don't forget to mention your name, class, and section in comments box for attendance. Also, the PDF of the chapter is available in the home tutorial in the green box above the videos at jmps.org.in. Now, as in the previous video, we completed our exercise 2A. I hope you understood and did the questions related to it given in your home task. Now, today in part 4 of our video, I'm going to start with properties of whole numbers. So let's start. Now, in properties of whole numbers, first of all, we will study about the properties of addition. In properties of addition, the first property is closure property. Now, closure property says that the sum of two whole numbers is always a whole number. That means if you will take two whole numbers and add them, then your answer will also be a whole number. So, that is A plus B is equals to C, where A, B and C are whole numbers. See, I have taken one example. 6 plus 11. 6 is a whole number. This 11 is also a whole number, and on adding them, what I will get? I will get 17, which is also a whole number. Hopefully, closure property for addition is clear to you. Now, next is commutative property. It says that A plus B is always equals to B plus A, where A and B are whole numbers. For example, suppose your A is 9 and B is 10, then A plus B is equals to 9 plus 10, and 9 plus 10 will gives us 19. And if I will add B and A, B plus A, then I will have 10 plus 9, which is again 90. So this means 9 plus 10 is same as 10 plus 9. Therefore, commutative property for addition holds. Hopefully, it is also clear to you. Now, next is additive property of zero. It says that on adding zero to any whole number, we will get the number itself. If A is any whole number, then A plus zero is same as zero plus A is equals to A. For example, if I will add 5 to 0, then what I will get? I will get 5. Or if I will add 0 to 5, then also what I will get? I will get 5. I hope third property is also clear to you. Now, next is associative property. Now, in associative property, we will take three whole numbers. Suppose A, B and C. Then A plus B inside the bracket plus C is same as or is equals to A plus inside the bracket B plus C is always true. For example, suppose A is 3, B is 10 and C is 5. Then in this LHS, that is A plus B inside the bracket plus C, we will put these values. A is 3, B is 10 plus 5. Now, first of all, I will solve this bracket. On solving this bracket, 3 plus 10 will give me 13. Now, to this 13, I will add this 5. So, on adding 5 to 13, I will get 18. And in the RHS, that says that A plus inside the bracket B plus C. Put the value of A. A is 3, B is 10 and C is 5. Now here B and C are inside the bracket. Now on adding 10 and 5, we will get 15. Now to this 15, I will add 3 and 3 plus 15 will again gives me 18. Therefore, what we will have? We will have A plus B inside the bracket plus C is same as or is equals to A plus inside the bracket B plus C. That means if we want to add two or more numbers, we can group them in any way. We can group them like this also, or we can group them like this also. Therefore, associative property for addition of whole numbers also holds. Hopefully, this property is also clear to you. Now, our next topic is properties of subtraction of whole numbers. And the first property is closure property. Now, this property states that whole numbers are not closed under subtraction. For example, if A is equals to 10 and B is equals to 3, then A minus B will be 10 minus 3 and 10 minus 3 will give us 7. Okay, 10 is a whole number here, 3 is a whole number, and here 7 is a whole number. But if I will try to subtract like this B minus A, then this means 3 minus 10. In this case, 3 is a whole number, 10 is also a whole number, but their subtraction, see, 3 is smaller than 10, so it can't be subtracted from 10 can't be subtracted from 3. Therefore, still, if I will try to subtract, what I will have? I will have 7, but with the negative sign, which is not a whole number, which is an integer. And as I previously told you that about the integers, we will study in our coming classes. So it says that this property states that on subtracting two whole numbers, we will not always get a whole number. Therefore, closure property for subtraction does not hold. Hopefully, this is clear to you. Now, next is commutative property. Commutative property says that subtraction of whole numbers is not commutative. That is, for any two whole numbers, A and B, A minus B is not equals to B minus A. For example, if A is equals to 10, B is equals to 7, then on putting the values in A minus B, we will have 10 minus 7, that is equals to 3, and B minus A is equals to B is 7 and A is 10. 7 minus 10, again the smaller number, from the smaller number we cannot subtract the bigger number. So still, if I will try to subtract, then 10 minus 7 will gives me 3, but the negative sign will come. Now a minus b is 3 and b minus a is minus 3. Both are not same or not equal. Therefore, commutative property for subtraction of whole numbers does not hold. Hopefully, commutative property for subtraction of whole numbers is clear to you. Now, the third property. Third property says that for any whole number A, A minus 0 is equals to A, but 0 minus A is equals to minus A. So this property also not exist in whole numbers as they are not same, because this is A and this is minus A. So A minus 0 is not equals to 0 minus A. Hopefully it is also clear to you. Now, next I have taken is associative property. Associative property. It says that subtraction of whole numbers is not associative. That is, for any three whole numbers, A, B and C, A minus inside the bracket B minus C is not equals to inside the bracket A minus B minus C. That means if I will do the grouping of these two numbers in the LHS, and here if I will do the grouping of these two numbers in the RHS and solve it, my answer will not come same. For example, if A is equals to 10, B is equals to 7 and C is equals to 3, then A minus inside the bracket B minus C is equals to, put the value of A is 10 minus B is 7. So inside the bracket 7 minus 3 will come. Now firstly solve this bracket. On solving, 7 minus 3 we will have 4, and 10 minus 4 will gives us 6. Now in RHS, inside the bracket we have taken A minus B and then minus C outside the bracket. Now this will be equals to, inside the bracket value of A is 10 minus value of B is 7, bracket close, minus 3. Now first of all solve this bracket. Solving this bracket, we will have 10 minus 7 as 3, and 3 minus 3 will gives us 0. So this implies that A minus inside the bracket B minus C is not equals to inside the bracket A minus B minus C. Therefore, associative property for subtraction of whole numbers does not hold. So, hopefully, today's work is clear to you. So, after understanding it, I hope you will be able to do the home task attached in the PDF form in description, and please don't forget to mark yourself as present by writing your name, class and section in comment box. For any doubts and queries, you can leave your message in comment section. I hope you like the video. Thank you.